Good morning, students. Next slide, please. Today we are going to discuss some basic things about plant taxonomy. Before going to plant taxonomy, we will be discussing why to study basic sciences. Basic sciences are mother of all applied sciences. I think you all of know about basic science and advanced sciences. Basic science means three different type of streams you study: chemistry, zoology and botany. Non-medical students, for them physics also is a basic science subject. And in applied sciences, you study biochemistry, biotechnology, microbiology, agricultural microbiology, and there are so many different applied subjects. Basic sciences, they are the basic things. Before, without having any knowledge of basic sciences, we can't study advanced sciences. So first of all, we will be studying why to study basic sciences. Then we will discuss about biological world, how many types of organism are there in our world, and then we will be discussing plants are important to us, why, because they fulfill all our demands. Then plant taxonomy and systematics, what will be the difference between taxonomy and systematics, and then we will cover history of plant taxonomy. You might be knowing that history of plant taxonomy dates back to more than 5000 years. Then importance of plant taxonomy and why plant taxonomy is a very good career opportunity, and in last, where to go for studying plant taxonomy. If you want to study plant taxonomy, where to go and where to get admission in different streams. Then in last, e-flora of India, platform for new enthusiasts. Sometime when you are in BSc or in MSc, you might not be having clear idea of different type of plant taxonomical aspects. So you can discuss all your queries in this platform. So next slide. First of all, basic difference between basic science and applied sciences. Applied science or basic science mein difference kya hai? Applied science designated to answer specific questions, whereas basic science motivated by curiosity. Suppose you are going through a road and you saw some different thing happening and you have a curiosity in mind why this is happening. All these type of questions will be clarified by basic sciences. But in applied sciences, suppose you have a specific problem. Specific problem means you have to carry lot of weight to 6th or 7th floor or 8th floor or higher. You have to devise specific mechanism for that, then that will cover under applied sciences. Basic sciences can answer fundamental questions about our world and lead to wide ranging applications and tremendous benefits and value. I think you all know about J.J. Thomson. Yes, J.J. Thomson, by research in pure science, I mean research made without any idea of application to industrial matters, but solely with the view of extending our knowledge of the law of nature. I will give just one example of utility of this kind of research, one that has been brought into great prominence by the war, I mean the use of X-ray in surgery. You all know the use of X-ray. For what purposes we use X-ray? Suppose you have any fracture in your bone, you can get that identified through X-ray. Now how was this method discovered? It was not the result of a research in applied sciences starting to find an improved method of locating blood wounds. This might have led to improved probes, but we cannot imagine it leading to the discovery of X-rays. Now this method is due to an investigation in pure science made with the object of discovering what is the nature of electricity. Basically, X-ray was devised for answering a physical phenomena, and that physical phenomena was nature of electricity. But now this X-ray is being used widely in medical sciences. Next slide, please. Thomson went on to say that applied science leads to improvement in old methods, while pure science leads to new methods, and that applied science leads to reforms, pure science leads to revolutions, and revolutions, political or scientific, are powerful things if you are on winning side. The important and very difficult question for these responsible for funding science is how to be the winning side. Basic science is very important culturally and economically. In 60s, there was a research being carried out in United Kingdom, and United Kingdom government, they asked general people what they want in sciences. They put two boxes. In one boxes you have to put your slip for basic science research, and another was applied science research. Applied science research was designated to devise any drug for diabetes. For basic sciences, that was related to different recombinant DNA technology experiments. And you will be surprised, most of the people were favoring applied sciences research, that was diabetes, insipidus or diabetes mellitus treatment. But government decided to go on research in bacteria and viruses, how recombinant DNA technology tools can be applied. But later on, that research related to recombinant DNA technology leads to development of human insulin through recombinant DNA technology method. However, that experiment takes very long time, but that was the result of basic science experiments that lead to development of human insulin in bacteria or other different type of vectors, using different type of vectors. Second, history has shown that building blocks of basic science can provide unexpected answers and tools that find important applications in engineering and medicine. An example that relate to some of our recent discussion is NMR. You all know that MNR, NMR, nuclear magnetic resonance. That is a very good tool in medical sciences, but this tool was also for some physical experiments, physics experiment, that was not for biological science or medical science experiment, but this basic science research we are doing in medical experiments. Next please. Another important example of basic science research is, in 1960 Shimomura studied a jellyfish, Aquaria victoria, why it glow green. This jellyfish emits green light. This experiment was started in 1960, and in 1980 some green fluorescent proteins extracted from this fish that were used by Martin Chalfie, and later on, next please, these green fluorescent proteins was used to have some experiments into related to earthworm, and later on these green fluorescent proteins were used to show how cancer cells migrate in our body. So research started in basic sciences in 1960 leads to a very good discovery, that is how cancer cells works and how cancer cell migrate in our body. And for this research in 2008, Shimomura, Chalfie and CN, they were awarded Nobel Prize for the discovery and development of GFP. Means this research leads to very good things in cancer biology, which are being used in different type of cancer research now. Next please. Now, what is biological world? You know two things, plants and animals. And what is another thing except plants and animals? You are a botany student, you study all things, viruses, bacteria, fungi, plants, and in zoology you study animals. So you have also studied five kingdom system of classification given by Whitaker. When it was given? That was given in 60s. But the basic thing we do, now there are three different type of domains. One is bacteria, another is archaea, and last is eukarya. So you also know what is the basic difference between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes, they don't have any well-defined nucleus, whether eukaryotic organisms, they have well-defined nucleus. And in eukarya, we study animals, fungi, plants, and also protists. Next slide, please. Continue. The four most important, most important divisions of the kingdom plantae are algae, fungi, lichens. They cover under thallophytes. Liverworts, hornworts and mosses we cover under bryophytes. Lycophytes and ferns we cover under teratophytes. And under spermatophytes we cover gymnosperm and angiosperm. Back please. Have you seen this question mark against fungi? Because we consider fungi as a separate kingdom, because fungi that is not autotrophic in nature, that is a heterotrophic type of organism. So sometime we consider fungi as a different kingdom. Next please. Taxonomic categories. In taxonomy, whether it is plant taxonomy or animal taxonomy, hierarchy is at the top is kingdom, then division, then class, then order, family, genus, and species is the smallest and most specific group in any taxonomic work. Grouped into genera, into families, families into orders, orders into classes, classes into phyla, and phyla into kingdoms. Sometimes we use, instead of division, another word that is known as phylum, particularly in zoological classifications. Next please. Plants are important to us. हमें किन तीन चीजों की जरूरत होती है? रोटी, कपड़ा and मकान. Basically all these things, bread, house and clothes, all are being fulfilled by plants. Approximately 7000 species of different plants are used as food by human beings. Water is also being provided by nature because water cycle is being governed by plants. Medicine, we get most of our medicines from plants. Air means oxygen we are getting from plants. Habitat means रहने की जगह हमारे लिए, that is also being provided by plants. Climate, and most important, plants store carbon and have helped in preserving CO2 out of the atmosphere. If CO2 will rise, what will happen? Global warming will be enhanced. So CO2 effect will be mitigated by more and more plants. Next please. What is plant taxonomy and systematics? Taxonomy and systematics, they are very much related to each other. Rather, we can say that taxonomy is part of plant systematics. In plant taxonomy, we basically classify, identify and give nomenclature to plants. But in systematics, we also study evolutionary relationship of plants and different type of organisms, how they have evolved from time to time. Next slide please. Then there is a specific, next, specific language for plant taxonomy. That is not English, that is not Hindi or Sanskrit or any other language. The language of plant taxonomy is Latin. Next. Why to use Latin language in plant taxonomy? Because this is the language of scholars, it is a dead language and does not continually change, politically neutral, very descriptive. Suppose you are saying something in your local dialect, that is Haryanvi. A single line means very differently for each and every person. कहते ना हर चीज के दो या तीन meaning निकाल लेते हैं. तो जो dead language नहीं है, they have different meanings of the same word or same phrase. Because Latin is a dead language, it is not being used by any human population, so it is politically neutral and it is very descriptive language. The example of its descriptiveness is Quercus macrocarpa is a bur oak which has large acorns. Macro means large and carpa means fruit. So this botanical nomenclature Quercus microcarpa, it is self-explanatory. Quercus, वो क्वर्कस की स्पेसिस जिसके फ्रूट्स बहुत बड़े बड़े होते हैं. एनी स्पीसीज ऑफ क्वर्कस हैविंग लार्ज साइज फ्रूट्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज क्वर्कस मैक्रोकार्पा. सो वी यूज लैटिन इन अवर डिफरेंट प्लांट टैक्सोनॉमिक वर्क्स. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. दिस इज द टैक्सोनॉमी इन रिलेशन विद डिफरेंट साइंसेस. टैक्सोनॉमी इज डिस्क्रिप्टिव. व्हेन वी स्टडी इन फील्ड, इन वी स्टडी लाइब्रेरी, वी टेक हेल्प ऑफ लाइब्रेरी. टैक्सोनॉमी इन हर्बेरियम, garden, computers. So these are the different aspects of taxonomy. The most important is observation, and after that description of the plant, and that different type of experiments, and then analytical, and ultimately we reach to our goal, that is called as plant taxonomy. Next please. Taxonomy history. History of plant taxonomy. I have earlier said that history of plant taxonomy is more than 5000 years old, and it starts with the period of Rig Veda, 3000 before Christ. The first descriptive analysis of plant taxonomy lies in Rig Vedas, and plants have been classified in Rig Vedas like this. औषधि, वनस्पति, वृक्ष, गुच्छे, गुल्म्स, त्रिंस, प्रतंस, वेलिस, एंड दीज आर द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स इन इंग्लिश. औषधि मीन्स एनुअल प्लांट्स, वनस्पति मीन्स ट्री बियरिंग फ्रूट्स विदाउट एविडेंट फ्लावर्स, वृक्ष मीन्स ट्रीज बियरिंग फ्लावर्स एंड फ्रूट्स. एंड दीज टू थिंग्स वी कैन स्पेसिफिकली से दैट स्पर्मेटोफाइट्स मीन्स जिम्नोस्पर्म्स एंड एंजियोस्पर्म्स. And later on, Charak and Susrut in his work, Charak Sanhita and Susrut Sanhita also give classification similar to the above. Susrut classified medicinal plants under 37 ganas or sections. Plant classification based upon their dietic properties was also attempted by Charak and Susrut. So history of plant taxonomy started from the Indian subcontinent. Next please. Next was the period of Greek period, Theophrastus in 372 287 before Christ. He started plant taxonomic work and he wrote one book that is De Historia Plantarum, in which he described about 480 kinds of plants. And after that came Roman period. With the advent of the Roman civilization, we came across certain important works towards plant classification, and the first classification in Roman period was given by Pliny the Elder in 23 to 79 after Christ. He was a Roman naturalist and he wrote Historical Naturalis. Next please. Taxonomic work. Then came Dark Age. Dark Age means no specific taxonomic work carried out between this period. And in this period some scientists though worked on plant taxonomy work. Albertus Magnus, Otto Grunfels, Jerome Bock, Cecil Pinho, जीन बोहिन एंड गैस्पर्ड बोहिन. बोहिनिया प्लांट का नाम सुना ना सभी ने? कचनार. दैट प्लांट वाज नेम्ड आफ्टर दीज टू ब्रदर्स, जीन बोहिन एंड गैस्पर्ड बोहिन्स. एंड देन जाओचिन जंग 1587 टू 1657 मींस दीज मोर देन 1600 इयर्स दैट वाज द कंप्लीट डार्क एज फॉर प्लांट टैक्सोनॉमी बिकॉज नो गुड वर्क वाज कैरिड आउट बिटवीन दिस पीरियड. नेक्स्ट John Ray, 1627 to 1705, he wrote another book, Methodus Plantarum, and he classified different plants as follows. At that time, difference between monocots and dicots were evident. Then, Pierre Magnol, Joseph Pitton, and then Rudolf Camerius, he also done some work on plant taxonomy. Next, please. Then came modern period. Modern period means period after Carl Linnaeus. Who gave the binomial nomenclature? Carl Linnaeus. So modern age of plant taxonomy started with the Carl Linnaeus. And Carl Linnaeus period was plant taxonomy in artificial system of classification. Then came Darwin. You know Charles Darwin? He wrote Origin of Species. Before Origin of Species, there was no idea about any phylogenetic history. There was no concept before Charles Darwin like evolution. Before Charles Darwin, we consider each and every species just as like as that was described. So after Darwin, all the classification given, they were phylogenetic system of classification, and before Charles Darwin, classification given were either natural or artificial system of classification. Next please. Carl von Linné, he was a Swedish botanist, born on May 23, 1701, and he wrote very good book, Species Plantarum, and that was written in 1753. And we consider deadline for modern plant taxonomy 1st May 1753. Any name given before this date 1st May 1753, we consider that name as non-valid, and all the names starting from this date given in Species Plantarum, they are valid names. Linnaeus defined some natural group in later works, Compositae, Graminae and Solanae. Although his system of classification was totally artificial system of classification, but he was able to group different type of similar phylogenetically similar groups into same category. Next, please. Then Bentham and Hooker, they were English botanists. They wrote a book, Zinda Plantarum, in 1863, and that was the most complete pre-evolutionary work, and that was considered as natural classification. And this work, Bentham and Hooker system of classification, that is being still followed all over world in many countries, in many important herbarias of the world. Then Charles Darwin and Alfred Wallace, their work came and they wrote book Origin of Species. Why Charles Darwin is considered as more than 100 years ago than his present time? Because he was able to think about idea of phylogenetic system. Darwin's publication on the Origin of Species was more than 100 years in future. Because why? At that time there were no paleobotany. What is paleobotany? Study of fossils. At that time there was no concept of paleobotany, no research on dinosaurs or other extinct animals was there, and there was no issue of connecting links. You know any connecting link? Like we consider cycas as connecting link and dinosaurs, they were not known. Before these things, he wrote this book, Origin of Species, and that was a great revolution in history of plant taxonomy. Next, please. After the work of Charles Darwin, Adolf Engler and Karl Prandtl, they gave another classification and they wrote the book, The Natural Plant Families, and this was the most modern classification before, around 50 years before. And he proposed most modern plant families, described proposed unisexual flowers, primitive and arranged plants according to primitive to advanced families. I think second year students, they know very well, you have to study two different type of system of classifications. Which one? Bentham and Hooker and Engler and Prandtl. Next, please. Then came the classification given by Charles Bassay. He was American scientist. In 1915, he gave natural phyletic system for flowering plants based on evolution, and he accepted Rennellian lines as most primitive, like Ranunculaceae, Magnoliaceae, all these families were primitive. And after this, Charles Bassay, most of the authors like Arthur Cronquist, Arun Takhtajan, Robert Thorne, many Russian and European scientists, they also follow the system of classification given by Bassay with slight modifications. Next. Now, latest system of plant classification that is being followed by most journals and herbaria of the world, that is APG 4 system of classification. APG means angiosperm phylogeny group. There were many disputes among different type taxonomists of different countries. So most of the taxonomists, working taxonomists, they started a group known as angiosperm phylogeny group at Missouri Botanical Garden, and they devised a classification known as APG system of classification. First APG system of classification was published in 2009, and 18 years after first APG system was published, first was published in 1998, and then APG 3 system was published in 2009, and now APG 4 system of classification came in 2016. Means this is the most recent system of classification. But in our country, most of the universities, they have not included APG 4 system of classification at BSc level. Although you have to study APG 4 system of classification in your MSc classes. Next, please. This is the complete chart of APG 4 system of classification. All the families here have been arranged according to their evolutionary history. Means primitive families first and advanced families last. Next, please. These are the different workers working in India in plant taxonomy field. And I would like to mention one important person. This is Dr. K. N. Gandhi, Kanchi N. Gandhi. He is presently in US Herbarium, and he is the most important person belonging to our country. This person is giving answer to each and every queries he received within 24 hours. Any queries from scientist, from any student, or even a school going student, he answer each and every queries related to plant taxonomy. And this is the list of different type of taxonomist. Pteridology, there is a great work given by S.S. Beer. And in fungal taxonomy, Professor N.S. Atri, T. Satyanarayan. And in phycology, R.K. Gupta, Ahluwalia. So different type of scientist working on different type of plant taxonomical aspects. Next, please. Literature on plant taxonomy. To study plant taxonomy, we have to refer different type of literature. An important literature is monographs. Monographs means it covers a specific group of plant, whether it is a family, whether it is a genera, and flora. Flora is the treatment of plants in a defined geographical area, like flora of Haryana, flora of Punjab, flora of Himachal Pradesh, or sometimes it can be geographical location also, like flora of Indo-Gangetic plains, like flora of Chakrata, Saharanpur and nearby provinces, like flora of Delhi, Hazara and Punjab. Next, research reports. These are the reports come in different type of taxonomic journals, and most important taxonomic journal in world is Taxon, that is being run by IAPT, International Association of Plant Taxonomy. Next, please. Plant taxonomy, why it is important, what is its scope and importance? Taxonomy help in research, basic research in different type of advanced sciences, in phytochemistry, genetical research, medicinal plant and traditional knowledge, microbiological, pharmacological. I would like to mention some different examples, like in phytochemistry research. You know about malaria, then you also know about quinine, and you also know about cinchona calicia. In different type of phytochemistry research, what we do? We extract alkaloids or other different type of secondary metabolites from plants, and we use them in medical research. So plant taxonomy is very important for phytochemistry research. Without having any idea about correct identity of plant, we can't go in phytochemistry research. I know an incident. A person from Gujarat Ayurved University was doing research in Swarsia chirayata, and he started their research on Swarsia chirayata. And after carrying out some work, he came to know that the plant he has chosen for his research, that is not Swarsia chirayata, that is another species of Swarsia and very much related to Swarsia chirayata. And incidentally, he came into a contact of a taxonomist, and only then he came to know that this species is not Swarsia chirayata, and after that he could have exact identity of Swarsia chirayata and continue his research with the help of that taxonomist having original Swarsia chirayata plant specimen. Then combat invasive alien species. You all know Parthenium hysteroporus, Congress grass. Congress, what is the importance of Congress grass? Congress grass is allergic to us. And from where it has reached to India? Congress grass introduced in India in 1960s from America. How? Seeds of Congress grass came during PL480 scheme. In that scheme, we import wheat from US, and in that wheat, this Congress grass came to India, and now it is spreading everywhere. Like this Lantana camara, that plant is also invading more and more new areas, and both these species, Parthenium hysteroporus as well as Lantana camara, they have reached up to height of 1500 meters. Means these have reached in Himalayan region also. And these are different invasive alien species. These are not Indian species. So in combating invasive alien species, we have to know clear identity of different type of plant specimen. Because plant specimen coming from different countries to India, they have to be quarantined first, whether they are having any fungal pathogen or any seed of unwanted these weeds. So for combating invasive alien species, we have to know each and everything about plant taxonomy. And this is also important in conservation biology. Conservation biology means conservation of different type of plants in their natural environment or artificial environment. If we know exactly about plant specimen, which is rare, which is extinct, or which is in future can be rare or can in future if any plant can be extinct, we have to conserve that species with the help of modern biochemical or modern biotechnological tools. Next please, taxonomy to combat invasive alien species, this we have discussed, and this is the list of plants. 5-6 years before, there was an incident in Pune. At that time, Giloy Bell, Tinospora cordifolia, that was being advertised by Baba Ramdev each and everywhere, and people were using that Giloy Bell in different type of ailments, particularly dengue and some viral fevers. And a family, they got this Tinospora cordifolia stem from the forest, and incidentally, by chance, some another plant of family Apocynaceae also got collected with the Tinospora cordifolia, and that plant was very dangerous for heart, and they consumed that plant in with Tinospora cordifolia, and they were in hospital next day. Out of the 5 family members, only 2 could be saved, 3 died due to the different different Apocynaceae climber. अगर उन्हें पता होता कि ये Apocynaceae का climber है, this is not Tinospora cordifolia, they should not have consumed that and their lives could be saved. So, having exact identity of medicinal plant is most important for not only for the scientist but for the common man also. So, this is the list. This is the original plant which is used as food, and this is the misidentified plant, looks like to this plant, and that can have poisonous effect, like allium, one species of allium that is edible, but another species is colchicum. Colchicin ka naam suna na sabhi ne? Colchicin, we use colchicin for what? We use colchicin for mitotic inhibition. So this allium species can be identified as colchicum. Consuming colchicum can be very dangerous for us. So this is the list. Next please. Plant taxonomy. Taxonomists identify and document Earth's biodiversity and organize this information in a form that can be utilized by others. A taxonomist, what a taxonomist do? Taxonomist identify, classify and collect different type of plant specimen. That he prepare a database, and that database can be used by different type of scientist. Systematic patterns are hypothesis of the history of life and form of the basis for modern classification. Like in APG 4 system of classification, what they have studied? They have studied the phylogenetic history of each and every family, and they have arranged all the families in a specific manner, that is phylogenetic manner. And we can say that this family came into existence first and this family came into existence last. And with the having with the help of this information, we can get help in different type of paleontological, paleobiological investigations. Like suppose a family came into existence 700 years before, and all the fossils belonging to that period, they will be of same age if they were found with the that family that was dominating before 600 to 700 years before. Next please. Phylogenetic patterns that result from systematic studies and classification derived from them have predictive value. What this means? You know Texas Baccata, Texas Himaliana, that species found in India at the height of around 3000 meters. And another species is Texas Brevifolia. So we are using Texas Brevifolia as a source of anti-cancer drug. Suppose Texas Brevifolia is not is there in our country or in any other country, and that country is having another species of Texas, like we are having Texas Baccata, Texas Himalayana, we can use cheap alternative source of that drug. Means if we are having a specific group like Texas, and we know the phylogenetic relationship of different Texas species, we can use most close species of Texas instead of using that specific genus like Texas Brevifolia, which is not having in our country. Systematics provide independent evidence for patterns of geographical geological changes. How Earth history has changed you know, there was a Gondwana landmass. पहले अलग-अलग सब continents नहीं थे, like Asia, Europe, South Africa, American continent और Australia, इस तरह continents नहीं थे. There was a single landmass that is known as Gondwana landmass. And how that gets separated, how different species has gone from one continent to another, and what is the relationship between one continent with another continent, like South African subcontinent, South African continent that was related to our Western Ghat. Sometime these two landmasses, they were together. So with the help of different systematic studies, we can predict that which part of Earth was close to which part of Earth. Next. India need more taxonomists. In Haryana, we don't have any good taxonomist to cater the need of students or universities or research. In Punjab also situation is the same. In Himachal, there is more or less same situation. We have some taxonomist in Rajasthan, a few in Delhi. But in most part of our country, particularly northern part of our country, taxonomists are not there. Like working taxonomists are not there. So we need more and more taxonomists, because we know that taxonomy can be used to solve so many problems, and it is very useful science. And there was an article in Nature. Nature is the most reputed journal. Nature and Science, these are the two most reputed journal all over world. And in this journal, this article was published by Muhammad Ajmal Ali and Ritesh Kumar Chaudhary in 2011. They studied complete data of taxonomists of India, and they published this paper, and they said that more and more taxonomists must be there in India to combat problems of taxonomy, because we are having more than 7% of the species found all over world. And 7%, aapko lag raha hoga 7% bahut kam hai, but 7% figure is very big, because there are more than 25,000 type of angiospermic plants are found in India. And identity, a type specimen, a different taxonomic description is still pending for many of the Indian plant species. Next please. Plant taxonomy, it is also a very lucrative career, because National Geographic Channel, Discovery Channel, BBC Earth and lot of folks, History Channel, all these channels, they require the help of taxonomists, because they present each and everything with their correct biological identity. So more and more taxonomists they are hiring to have different type of videos. And you have seen many documentaries like Secret World of Plants, Secret Life of Plants, Private Life of Plants. In these type of documentaries, they have millions and millions of views on YouTube also. You can see all these documentaries on YouTube, and they require the services of plant taxonomist. There are few plant taxonomists working in these type of media houses, and some internationally reputed also, Michael Pollan, David Attenborough, Judy Dench, Srikant Ingalhalikar, Pradeep Krishan. And one name, Pradeep Krishan, you all might be knowing, Arundhati Roy. He is the husband of Arundhati Roy, and he is a filmmaker. And presently he is preparing some documentary on trees of central India and trees of Delhi. He has very good inventory, and he has written a book on trees of Delhi also. Next please. Plant taxonomy, where to study? If you like plant taxonomy, where we have to go for studying plant taxonomy? These are the list of institutions, starting from Botanical Survey of India, NBRI Lucknow, National Botanical Research Institute, then Calicut University Kerala, Sivaji University Kolhapur. These two universities, particularly Calicut University Kerala and Sivaji University Kolhapur, they are considered as holy places for plant taxonomists, because most of the research work going on in these two universities, Calicut University Kerala and Sivaji University Kolhapur, that is more than the total work done by other different type of universities in India. And this is a different type of places. Punjabi University Patiala, for having fungal taxonomy, you can go to Punjabi University Patiala. Punjabi University Chandigarh, very good work on orchid taxonomy and grasses taxonomy is there. HP University Simla, for ethnobotany, you can join this university. HP University Simla, University of Kalyani and Savitribai Phule University Maharashtra, Norology Godrej Center for Plant Research. Norology Godrej Center for Plant Research, they are isolating some chemicals from the plants and using them in modern research for studying plant taxonomy as well as phytochemistry. You can join Norji Godre Center for Plant Research. In University of Kashmir, J&K, you can go for studying different type of alpine flowers, alpine plants. So this is the list. Although other universities also, they are offering MSc in plant taxonomy or related fields. But this is list of 24 very good universities and institutions carrying out work on plant taxonomy. Next, please. Now, eFlora of India. Basic information about eFlora of India. This is the Google group. Initially started in 2007 by a railway chief engineer known as J.M. Garg, Jagmohan Garg. Basically, he is also from Haryana, belonging to a very small town of Haryana that is known as Palwal in Faridabad district. And this group is world's biggest group in plant taxonomy. No money is involved, no membership is there, and you don't have to have any good idea about plant taxonomy. Just join this group and you can satisfy your queries to plant taxonomy by joining this group. Next, please. You can join this group by sending email to itpmods@googlegroups.com, or you can go to this site, sites.google.com/site/eFlora of India. And these are the moderators of this group. All these moderators, they are helping different type of students, different type of scientists working in plant taxonomy, and they are helping each and every person. And it is not necessary that this person will give answer to your query or this person will give answer to your query. Any of these person who will read your mail first, he will reply to you to satisfy your queries related to plant taxonomy. Next, please. Thank you very much.